once, as I request the timer not to start now, the speaker has to speak impromptu and someone has to give her a topic or a suggestion on what she can speak on so that she can start speaking on it. So me being her evaluator, I'll be asking her questions and she will speak impromptu on every topic for 1 or 2 minutes. Her total time is 5 to 7 minutes. Okay. So let me start off with the first question. Yes. Now, my first question to you, Rachna, is how far do you think have we come along with our education system in India?
Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests. This is a pep talk with me by Toastmaster Ravi Mittal, where he is going to ask me a few questions from the topics covering the generic part of my life. The first one that he has asked me is education. How far have we come up with the education system in our country? To begin with, let me define education in the terms which I understand. The propensity to learn leads to education. It's nothing but your heart's desire to seek out the best. I don't know how many of you have seen the movie 3 Idiots, where the protagonist says, "Jahan gyan milna hai, better love it." Nothing but gain from wherever you can. Coming to the education system of India, I believe it has come a long way. Considering the fact that we now have the independence of choosing our courses, it is not just the structured approach of delivering the rote lessons which we learn and we do the bell job of coming back and repeating things that have been stuck to us since ages. Now we have the ideas which we can develop, more of the practical education. I would like to end the answer in a small sentence which I take from the novel, which is my philosophy of life, Fountainhead. Where the person says, "I stand at the end of no tradition. I may perhaps stand at the beginning of one." This is the way the students of today have come to feel, considering the great educational system that has now been in place.
Thanks, Rachna. I guess I got my answers. Now, let's talk about environment. You're reading a lot of about environment. Do you think the global warming thing actually exists, or is this farce?
I have got this question from many people, and let me tell you, there's a brilliant book by Richard Nelson, A Cool Look at Global Warming. Having read that book, I've come to know that there are various ways in which you can interpret the change in temperature and climate that has been happening in the world. But to specifically answer your question on my opinions and beliefs, scientific evidence do prove that global warming exists. Reasons being, the temperature is not just rising in the normal way that it has been done in the ice ages, but there has been a drastic change. You can see the climate variation yourself. The weathers have become extreme, the summers have become hotter and longer, and the winters have become shorter and more extreme. Therefore, looking at the evidences, looking at the temperature increase of 0.3 degrees Celsius per year, looking at the fact that the glaciers have definitely come down, melted down, and the sizes have receded, I would like to believe that it has come to a stage where we must now take action.
Right, looks like you're covered right here. Alright, small family, big family, or nuclear family?
A huge family. I come from a joint family. My family has 11 members. My grandma, my parents, my uncle, aunt, 3 cousins, my brother and sister. We've lived in such a family for almost 18 years, after which we had to part ways, considering that there is no huge space to accommodate the growing children, considering that I have become a cracker, a chakri from a Gujari. But I definitely believe that bigger families have much more bonding because you have much more time to share the joys, the sorrows, and your feelings. I would like to say that the time when I was coming to Hyderabad from Delhi to start my job, I have a cousin who is 10 years younger than me. The moment I entered into the cab to go to the station, he has been very encouraging in saying, "Dee, you go, you do great things, you send me a lot of gifts, considering that you're going to start a job." But as soon as I entered the cab, the statement that he said was, "Dee, aap sach mein ja rahe ho? Didi, are you really leaving?" And that was something that touched my heart. I don't think that kind of bonding and feelings are available or possible in the nuclear family. So definitely, the family is there for me.
Right. Now, coming to family, there is also about religion. People who believe in religion are successful sometimes. People who do not believe in religion are also successful. Also.
Religion is a matter of personal choice, and this is a Toastmasters platform. I am not allowed to speak on it, so I will take it in terms of but I would definitely like to say that I would have considered this, I would 4 years back or so. I have learned Bhagavad Gita, I have learned Ramayana, and I know almost all the mythological stories by heart, which many of the so-called very spiritual and religious people do not know. So I believe that knowing it and questioning it would add more rather than being blindly religious or very religious.
Nice. So a lot of questions. Right. So why Toastmasters?
Toastmasters is a platform which lets me speak without people throwing fruits, tomatoes and eggs. It is a platform where I speak and people listen without making those horrible noises which they usually do when I am speaking at another public gathering. It is a place where I get applause when I am speaking on the stage instead of saying you shut up and I'll go back to your seat. It is a place where I have networked with the leaders of today and tomorrow with their thoughts presented in a very coherent manner, which enables me to grow and learn along with them. That's why I believe it's one of the platforms I would love to be associated with for the rest of my life.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ravi, for getting us talking to you.
Let's take a minute to give feedback to Toastmaster Rachna.